2021, guys. It's hard to believe, right? You know, I can remember as a kid signing my name on the top of the paper in grammar school, saying, I wonder what it's going to be like in like 1990 or 95. Now we're like 2021. Welcome back, new viewers. My name is Tom. This is the Tom Reefer channel. What I wanted to show you today, guys, is what I do to prepare for vacation. I'm going to be away a week, so no water change Wednesday or next Sunday video.
All right, guys. I'm having my coffee on New Year's Day. It's about 9:11, and I have my tank set to come on at about 9:12. Here they come. Let's see. Oh, there they go. See? So what I thought I'd do is just show you how things work and how I operate before a vacation today. So they come on at around 9. My 20-gallon, that comes on a little bit earlier. That comes on at about 7. So does the 10-gallon down below. That comes on a little earlier too. These two are set up on what's called CASA. I set those up on this app. It's awesome. They're Wi-Fi, and they come with a, see, I have several on there, several devices. You could put one per plug. It's a plug that you plug into your wall, and then you can set it Wi-Fi. So I have the PICO here. I have the Kessel A80 on the 5-gallon, and then I have the Kessel A80 over the 20-gallon, which doesn't come on until about 11 o'clock. See, that's still off. So that's how it works in the morning here. And here's what the plugs look like, guys. The blue light means it's on. This one is for the 20-gallon tank with the Kessel A80. That hasn't come on yet. Here's the other one over here. That's for the 5-gallon tall. So they work great. I've had them for a year now, and they're not really expensive either.
Let's start out with ATO.
All right, guys. So what I like to do before I go away is get everything nice and clean. So I'm gonna clean the glass. I'll just slide this back a little, and then I'm gonna clean the glass. It also helps me gauge how much is grown while I'm gone too, you know, without doing anything. Now remember, I don't have any feeding going on in here. I'm not going to touch the sides or the back because that's part of our experiment. This comes in pretty handy, this top, so that way I can keep the light on there and you can still see it. What I'm going to do is refill the ATO back there. All right, so let's go get some water.
So Sylvia and I are going to Vermont to ski, Stratton, Vermont, and for a few days, then we'll go into the city. We're gonna bring our masks, practice social distancing with everybody else except each other.
All right, I always have some RODI made up. I have the 5-gallon jug and a smaller size cup to pour. That way I can just bring this right back in there and pour it in. That's filled. All right, now let's get some kalkwasser and add a little in there. Here it is. This is what I use, Julian Sprung's version of kalkwasser. This is a half teaspoon. I'm just going to put a quarter teaspoon in there, if that. Put that in, and then I'm going to stir it around. And now I'll fill this one up. Remember, this services PICO, 20, and the 5. Now let me show you something in here, guys. This is an issue that I've confronted before, and you may have. This
settling out, so to speak, of the calcium hydroxide, the kalkwasser, can get to a point where you're always going to see some fallout. This is never going to dissolve what's left here. This could be some of the compounds that aren't going to dissolve. So over time, I usually do 2 refills without adding more kalkwasser to it. So I'm going to try 1 more, stir all this up, and then see how much is left when I get back after vacation. If there's still an amount left like this in the bottom, then I'll empty it and add new. And I'm gonna stir this like I do the other. So I'll see you next time. I keep note in my brain, what's left of it, on how much settled out on the bottom. If the same amount appears to settle out, then I just know it's excess compound. As far as feeding, guys, I really don't feed at all while I'm gone. Fish have a gland that when they begin to sense that they're not eating enough or getting enough food, this gland provides them for long lengths of time without food. And I've also fed with auto feeders. Here it is, guys. It's by EHIEM. I didn't want to make this a how-to, but I just wanted to show you. You put batteries in here. As you can see, it takes 2 AA's. Okay, and see what it does now? It's spinning. You take this off. This comes out also, like I had before. You put the food inside there. This goes back on. It'll feed manually if you just want to hit this. See what it does is it spins 1 revolution, and as it spins, the food pours out the bottom. You definitely don't want it to overfeed your tank, or you come back with a completely fouled tank. So you want to make sure it's a good one and it works right, and it doesn't overfeed your tank. So to be on the safe side, what I did is I put some tape on here to make the hole smaller. This was the smallest setting here, and even that was allowing too much food to go into the tank. You can set it for once a day. All right, now I'm gonna have to show you. This section here goes over the edge of your tank. I believe it'll work on rimless and non-rimless tanks. You tighten it in onto the glass, and then you fill it with food, and you'll program it, and then it'll do that. Tank is looking awesome, by the way, isn't it, guys? This citron goby here, he gets kind of skinny when I go away for a week because he's very active. So I may put the fish feeder on there. Clown, he'd be fine for a week. I don't want to starve my mandarin either. Not starve, but you know what I'm saying, guys. I like to do water change too, guys. I like to do water changes on all the tanks before I go. So what I'll do is I'll mix up a large quantity of water, and large for me will be 10 gallons. I'll change 5 in the 20, about 2 in the PICO, and I'll change the rest, which would be about 3, right? 5, 2, 7, 8, 9, 10. 3 in the 5-gallon. What else should I do before I go away? I know there's something I'm forgetting. I also want to test the water in the 10-gallon for phosphate. It's been a little over a week since I put in the sand bed. And remember, we tested the sand bed and it was like 0.5 from Fish Guy Mike's. So I put it in the tank, and let's see what it's going to be today. All right, so we're going to test phosphate now, guys, in the 10-gallon. Turn this on. I have a sample ready. Put it in here. Okay, we're gonna add the reagent. And 2 minutes of this. Okay, we're gonna put it inside and count down. My guess, guys, is this is going to be a little high. And let me tell you why. Remember when we tested the sand from Fish Guy Mike's? When I tested the sand after being in about 2 gallons of fresh salt water overnight, 24 hours, I tested and it was 0.5. And within the live rock, there was a buildup of phosphate in them also. I did not test the live rock when I brought them home. I had mentioned this in my other video. The phosphate will reach equilibrium. It will lower and then it will come out of the rock or live sand and go back to where it was until it's completely eliminated, which takes a long, long time. A lot of water change over a long period of time. And not adding more phosphate to the tank. Let's see what it comes out to now. All right, 0.32. It did reduce a little bit because of the volume of water, but it's not zero by any means. It's not really low. This is still a bit high, but I would accept it, because 0.3 of my 20 gallon doesn't seem to be bothering anything.
All right, guys, that should do it for this one, right? My first I Agree 2021. So look, have a great New Year's. Be positive. You can't fight what is. So you might as well make it positive. All right, have a great day, have a great start to the new year, and I'll see you when I get back, week from today, but I think I don't know when I'm going to do the next video. It'll probably be the Wednesday after I get back, which is next Sunday. All right, take care now, guys. Have a good one. This is such a boring video today, guys. I'm sorry, but it's just all I can do right now. All right, guys, that should do it for... I agree. Yeah. All right. Take care, guys. Have a good one. Ah. All right. What else can I show you before I go away?